my guys and girls and my friendly non-binary pals. Today, we are taking another trip down memory lane. And we are going to play Distraint Poxit. Pocket Pixel Horror. Now, I played this game as a kid. It's another game I played as a kid, but yeah. Let's get into it. My humanity was for sale. Okay. And I sold it. Why would you sell it? That very moment sent me into decay. Now, I never understood this as a kid. I was like, oh, Pocket Pixel game. Looks like fun. Probably not going to understand it. This is my story. And these are my regrets. Alright. Options. This lady. Like, where would I go? This is all I have. Oh, she's crying now. Now you're making me feel bad. I'm sorry. I shouldn't be crying like this. There are just so many memories here.
I understand, madam.
Oh, yeah, my manners. Would you like to have a cup of tea?
It's a cup of tea. A cup of tea. I'd rather have a cup of coffee if possible. Now, I want, how many of you are coffee drinkers and how many of you are actually tea drinkers? I'm both. Oh, of course. Give me a second, young man. I hate my voice. Might as well look around while we're in. And that's how you get your ass killed sometimes. We don't always want to, like, sometimes if you're at someone's house, you don't always want to snoop. And you always want to be aware. Right now, you, in this time and day and age, you always want to be aware of your surroundings. And keep a very close eye on your drink. And if someone's making you a drink at their house, always... I don't know how would you say it. But always keep up, like... Be aware of what I'm trying to say. Okay, if you want to, anything like that. It's a rocking chair. Every granny has one. Not my grandma. My grandma doesn't have a rocking chair. How okay would I do this, like, walk around like a wedding photo of Mr. and Mrs. Goodwin? Though I believe she's a widow now. Let's see. Oh boy! Oh, it's yay! No! Saw that. Get me the hell out of here. Get me 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 out of here. Hell no. Don't drink it. Don't drink the coffee. I'm sorry, dear. I'm afraid I ran out of coffee. Can I get you something else instead? No, thank you, madam. Listen, you will have to move up at the end of the line. Very true. Sorry, man. Sometimes old people can be scary in video games, and so can kids. I'm more scared of old people and kids in video games than I am anything else, to be honest. So power is, and my cat is deciding to be destructive and destroy everything. So I'm just a very destructive alien at times, but most cats are power. So I just want to get away from it. Thank you. I mean, we don't get a flashlight, we get lights in this game. I wonder where you stick the ice cube. I mean, it would melt in your pocket originally. Huh? I don't need to pee. It's been like, oh no, years since I played this game. What the? It's an old oven. And she's like, right now, like, I'm trying to keep out of my puppy. She's laying on my lap, and right now she's trying to chew everything in sight. So, and by the way, this is a mobile game, so if you guys want to play it for yourself, you know, go ahead and knock yourself out. It's empty. Apartments. Oh, yeah, actually, you know what I really want to do? Get the hell out of here. So, I'm going to cut to a quick... Okay. Until I find the key, this is going to be a while until I find the key. Okay, so I finally figured it out. Fake for a minute. Ice cube plus heat. I'm out. So I'm sound. I don't hear shit. The window is boarded. Why is the window boarded? What are you trying to keep in or keep out? You know, if you kind of understand a bit of that reference, good job. Hey, that's my sack! And my dog always is a real bad sock. Also, just to say, she knows how to get a hold of my socks. I could put them anywhere in the house and she would find a way just to get a hold of me. It's kind of weird. These are books that got money. Okay. Empty. Why is every drawer empty around here? There's something here. Finders keepers. You found a horror book. What are we gonna do with the book? The hell am I supposed to do with the book? I think I know. I bet you it's one of those places where you put a book there and it like moves. A finance book. Oh! Hell no, I'm out. You see it now? I'm not going back. Not going back. I'll make you go back. I don't exactly know what this game is about. All I know is it's playing as some type of guy. You whip something or you're trying. All I know is that we're solving puzzles. And it's a horror game. Done. Alright, give me okay. Room 3, apartment 2, 3, 2, 3. Expired lady out. someone could rob you easily with there.
I felt both joy and sorrow. Soon I would get my partnership. But at the price of humanity, would it be worth it? I don't know. Would it be worth it? And what do you mean the price of your life? Because apparently, this game just got creepy. You got... How did it get? There's an elephant in the room. You mean this? Seriously? Oh my god. Oh, it was just a little nightmare. Get the reference? Just a nightmare. That was a morning already. What a day that was. Wait. So, that wasn't a nightmare? That shit really happened? That really happened? All stores are really drinking here. The roof is leaking. The apartment. So I'm getting the suit on. Then, you see, with me, I get dressed, then I have something to drink. And eat. So save our game. It's empty. Wow, do I even have these drawers? TV. Coffee first. Okay, I get the employee. We're getting your coffee, sir. Okay, I need some water for the I don't have to do your dirty work. Not long anymore and I get to move out from this... At least you got a place, you know? Some people will be happy to have some water, you know? A place to live. Some people will be happy to have just a place to live. Come on, do something. No, don't do it. Is he really? That's nasty, man. It's not that important to have that caffeine. Oh my god. That is nasty. Bro, that's gross. Nobody needs to know. No, I still have a little dignity left. Oh, thank goodness. You know what? I would never. No. I don't care if I ain't got nothing to drink. I would never in a million years do this. It's a funny story, actually. When one of my cousins was just a baby. He was still a kid. And, it's kind of fucked up. Not sure how hygienic this is. Yeah, but you were gonna do it from the toilet, dude. But man, gotta get his coffee. There are some... Yikes. Anyway, back to the story. So, like, one of my younger cousins, when he was just a baby, and, we were thirsty, we were just sitting around the house, and so, he literally, we didn't know. Thankfully, none of us drank it. Because, we didn't know where he got the water from. First, we thought he got it from the faucet, but then again, we realized he couldn't reach the faucet. None of us drank the water, thankfully, though, because he was getting water from the toilet. And you know how it was only me that found it out. I was like, where are you getting the water from? And then he showed me he was getting it from the toilet, and he was like, oh. Luckily, we were all looking at each other, and was like, none of us drank it. Whew.
It was like, yeah. Okay, I watched some telly. Who called it telly? It's called television art. Right nowadays, it's just called TV or Shima Progress. What was that noise? Yeah, I heard it too. What was that? Hey, you come from the bathroom. And yo, I swear to God, investigate it. You know, this is probably... As a kid, I didn't want to... If, like, when I was a kid and I lived with my grandparents, and one... How did they get in my house? I would freak out if you just walk into my living room and see my parents are standing there. Well, my mom. I would freak out if I see my parents are standing in the living room. I was like, how'd you get in my house? It was my mom. My mom. Papa. And my mom. And my papa. Took my coffee. But I don't care. You can have it. Oh, no, dear. It's our little window. I can see, I can see that now. He said, you don't want to take some coffee already. Although it tastes sweet. He gonna kill his parents for that unhygienic coffee. No, not at all. Well, you're not here. You look so pale. Aren't you supposed to be here? Cutscene, it started raining blood outside. So I feel like ever since we kicked that Mrs. Goodwin, bitch done cursed us. Hallucinates. Could you imagine having that? I mean, when I was, I think we used to have someone in the family. Yeah, one of our younger cousins. He used to hallucinate bad. We never knew why, but he would always like he had nightmares. He's like, we never understood why. But he would have nightmares about this, like this tall man in a suit. That's all he would tell us. He's like, and then one night we were, I was bringing my dog inside. We had this big, big backyard. It was Big Fence backyard. And what was that? Oh, this drink too. Anyway, we had like this big backyard and it was like the middle of the night. It was dark outside. You know, common horror type story, how it starts. And I had to go get my dog and bring him inside because I always bring him inside before I go to bed. And I can't, and I shit you not, there was someone standing in our backyard. And it's like, how that, did they even get over the fence? Because we had like a, we kind of have a shortest tall fence. I mean, it wasn't tall enough to jump over, but it was tall enough to, I mean, someone could climb it, duh. But anyway, there was someone just standing there in a white hoodie. All I remember is there was a person standing there in the back area of the backyard in a freaking white hoodie. I was terrified out of my freaking wits. And, grabbed the dog, I ran back inside, and that's all I remember, and, I saw him when I went to grab my dog. I picked up my dog, and he kept growling, and growling, and growling, and I was like, there's nothing there. And then I looked to where he was looking, and that's where I saw the person. It's like, oh, I never ran so quickly inside the house. And my grandma was like, what's wrong with you? I was like, there was someone in our backyard. We lived, like, right next to an old church at the time. And, I mean, people still went to that church. But it was, like, an old, kind of like an old church that's been around for years. So, yeah, there's my story with that one. It was rough yesterday, but I decided to carry on. Though, I would lie to you if I said I didn't think of Mrs. Goodwin. Anyway, Mr. Taylor was on the next name on my list. He lived in the... You know we gonna die. We gonna die. We sure as hell gonna die this time. He lived in the forest as a hermit. He had no debt, but the city wanted to expropriate his property. I hope I pronounced that right. I can't talk some news. They built a highway there. I traveled to him so I can seize his property. Yikes. You know, if this dude lived in the middle of the forest, he could be like, he could be one of those people or creepy weirdos that stay in the middle of the forest. No offense if you live in the middle of nowhere and you watch my videos, I'm so sorry. His cabin should be here somewhere. I would never want to live in the middle of a forest. Because you never know what lurks out in the darkness at night. And if you're like me, I'm one of those people that can't stand going outside at night. Due to so many bad experiences as a kid. And I actually got another story for you guys. So when my cousin, when he was just a babe, he was still a little kid, he liked to play games and stuff like that. But one time we were, so we had like a sliding door and stuff and all that in our backyard. We still stay place, took, the story takes place from the last story I just told. But anyway, we, and we didn't have a curtain up there or anything. And my cousin one night, he was the second youngest, and he was, when all of us were still awake, I was in my room with my other cousin because she was asleep, and I was up on my phone or either on my Xbox playing a game. And, oh my god, I never heard someone scream so desperately and terrified and loud. It was scary because all we heard, the kitchen was next to my grandma's room, and that's where the sliding door area was, in the kitchen. And all I know is that he was screaming at the top of his lungs. So his mom ran in, I ran in, grandma ran in, we're like, "What are you screaming at?" And he just kept pointing outside the window and said, "He's there, he's there, he's there." And we all looked and we didn't see anything. So it was pretty a story, and... Yeah, they say only kids can see things that some other people can't see. So it's actually kind of scary and terrifying. Hello, either he's not home or he's ignoring me. Probably he's ignoring you, or guess what, I don't know. He's locked. Did he just break in or something, or break and entering? I feel like we're gonna have to do some breaking and entering. Everything's locked around here. Why that statue look like a frog? And then another night, hello. You must be Mr. Taylor. I am. My name's Taurus. Nice to make acquaintances. Please drop the act and let me hear your threats. Okay, before we continue on, I'm gonna finish my story. Then another night it happened. He was just, I don't know, he just stood there and I was coming to the kitchen to get me a drink. Everyone else, it was kind of middle of the night, and he usually wakes up in the middle of the night, and so did I. And he was just standing there in the middle, like, in the middle area where the sliding door was, and just standing there, like, right in front of the sliding doors. And he just stood there, and it's like, okay. So I'm just standing there like, okay, is something wrong? It's like, so I looked outside, and I didn't see anything. And we had kind of had lights, so we would be able to see then. And I didn't see anything out there, but he sure saw something because I literally waved my hand in front of his face. He wouldn't flinch. And then I was shaking him and everything. I didn't want to wake up anybody because, you know, some people are pretty grumpy when you wake them up. And I finally snapped him out of it, and he's just like, and I was like, and he just started crying. I'm like, "What's wrong with you?" He's like, "He was standing right outside again." And I'm like, "Who are you talking about?" He's like, "The man in the black coat." And I was like, "What man in the black coat?" She's like, "He has no..." And he was like, "He has no face. He has..." Not a black coat. Black suit. But, ever since that, those few days, those nights... And this went on for a long, long, long time. And so anyway, we ended up having to put like a curtain there because after a while he would not even go into my grandma's room. And that's where he usually liked to sleep, in his grandmother's room. He wouldn't go in there at all. And it was sad but terrifying to us. After a couple of weeks, we start talking about moving and everything. And it was really on this particular night. I was the only one awake, everyone else asleep. I was had insomnia bad, so I was up packing, still packing up more stuff because we were moving. And of course, this time I went to go get a drink again. It's the only one awake. And I shit you not, I kid you not, there was someone literally standing like a bit distance in the middle of the yard and just standing there. And then I remember my young cousin telling me about a man with no face and in a black suit. And I was like, oh, shit. So I just stood there and just like, oh, okay. At first, I was like, you know, I'm probably hallucinating or I'm just tired. But then I went and got my water, and then I kind of splashed my face. I was like, you know, I'm probably just tired. So then I walked back past, and he was still standing there. And I'm like, okay, you know what? Time for bed. I did go to sleep that night, and I was a bit terrified, but I did go to sleep because I had my dog. And usually when you have a dog, sometimes you feel protected. Anyway, you know what? I'm going to cut this video short, and I thank you for listening to my ramblings and my stories. I always have a story to tell. Funny thing about me, I always have a story to tell. This game is called Destroying Pixel. Please check it out on the App Store. And don't forget to like and subscribe, my fellow friends. And please, if you can, share the video to your friends and family, you know. Share the video, like this video, and check out my channel for more. I am Melon Moons, and I'm rolling out.